Okay, we've got an emergency situation. Tim, can you put him on emergency condition with the ventilator? We've got a decent, we've got convulsions.
This is the Radboud University Nijmegen Medical Center, located in the city of Nijmegen, the Netherlands.
It's here. We
The Department of Neonatology, together with the Departments of Pediatric Surgery, Cardiology and Extracorporeal Circulation, is one of the two ECMO centers in the Netherlands for neonatal and pediatric ECMO. Since the start of our program in 1989, almost 400 newborns and infants have been treated with ECMO. Our center has received the ELSO's Center of Excellence Award 2 times.
Venous air, emergency situation. You put him on.
Yeah, I put
him on. I'll put the pressure on the venous cannula because of the convulsions.
Okay.
Can you see it?
Yeah.
You just witnessed an emergency situation on ECMO. Luckily, this was only a team training. In the past, we used to train our staff in the animal lab with a little lamp on ECMO.
And nowadays we use video-assisted real-time simulation. And the use of real-time simulation allows us to practice high-risk, low-frequency emergencies on ECMO without endangering real patients. It's performed in a clinical realistic simulation setting, and it also allows us to observe integration of not only theoretical knowledge but also practical skills and non-technical skills while under real time pressure and with active participation of candidates.
So we needed a simulator to incorporate in our simulation program, and at present day there is no commercially available ECMO simulator which suits our needs. And we thought maybe we could develop it in our own facility. And to do that, we had to identify what kind of emergencies we want to simulate. And you can divide those groups into kind of emergencies, and technical ECMO machine related emergencies and patient related emergencies, like tubing failure or pump failure in the ECMO related emergencies, and cardiac tamponade or hemothorax in patient related simulations. So we made a list about 20 emergencies which our simulator should be able to simulate. And during the development process we added some other features like a wireless control, so we didn't have to be present in the room to control the simulator. And we use the simulator in all aspects of our simulation program now. So we can use it in the skill training and we can use it in the big simulation sessions we do. And with this simulator we completed our ECMO simulation program. So we have step one with the e-learning and lectures for theoretical knowledge gathering, step two for skill training, and step three for integrate all those skills and theoretical knowledge into a real life scenario. And with this simulator I think we have completed a real good simulation program, and it's one of the reasons why we got our Center of Excellence twice.
I go again so we can check for the ventilator problem. Now we have improved circulation and we have convulsions that stopped, and we still do not have a cause. We treated it with phenobarbital. We have to make an ultrasound of the brain because I think he has a bulging foot and now he has an intracerebral bleeding.
Okay.
Wait.
Okay.